The International Space Station, ISS, is a modular space station, or habitable artificial satellite, in low Earth orbit. It is a multinational collaborative project involving five participating space agencies: NASA, United States; Roscosmos, Russia; JAXA, Japan; ESA, Europe; and CSA, Canada. The ownership and use of the space station is established by intergovernmental treaties and agreements. The station serves as a microgravity and space environment research laboratory in which specific research is conducted in astrobiology, astronomy, meteorology, physics, and many other fields. The ISS is suited for testing the spacecraft systems and equipment required for possible future long-duration missions to the Moon and Mars. As of today, 15 countries have visited the ISS or a part of it in some way or another. That includes Russia, which boasts one of the most capable space agencies besides the United States. China, on the other hand, isn't one of them. Despite its interest in collaborating on the International Space Station, China was officially barred from visiting by the United States in 2011. Initially, China's five-year-old space agency was viewed as too young and inexperienced to offer any useful contributions to the International Space Station. Soon after the Chinese developed their own space stations and sent astronauts to space to visit them, it became clear that this wasn't the case. Later, trust issues would become the source of the United States' unwillingness to work with China on the International Space Station. Two matters of distrust, including the use of anti-satellite weapon and the hacking of Jet Propulsion Laboratory intellectual property, fueled a bill passed in 2011 to ban China from the International Space Station. In 2013, officials at NASA Ames prohibited Chinese nationals from attending Kepler Science Conference too. A number of American scientists boycotted the meeting, with senior academics either withdrawing individually or pulling out their entire research groups. Representative Frank Wolf wrote a letter to NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden saying that the restrictions only applied to bilateral meetings and activities between NASA and the Chinese government or Chinese-owned companies, whereas Kepler Science Conference 2 is a multilateral event. NASA later reversed the ban and admitted a mistake in barring individual Chinese nationals who did not represent their government in an official capacity. During China's 2019 Chang'e 4 mission, NASA collaborated with China to monitor the moon lander and Yuto 2 rover on the lunar far side using NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter. NASA was able to do so by getting congressional approval for the Pacific interaction of sharing data with researchers globally. Even today, China isn't allowed to visit the International Space Station, but other space agencies apart from NASA have expressed how they wouldn't mind having China on board. After all, it's an international collaboration that conceived the International Space Station in the first place. And with more brilliant minds in outer space, humanity could spring forward into the next era of technological advancements in space. China is building its own space station named Tiangong. It's placed in low Earth orbit between 340 and 450 kilometers, or 210 to 280 miles, above the surface. The Tiangong space station, once completed, will be roughly one-fifth the mass of the International Space Station and about the size of the decommissioned Russian Mir space station. The Chinese space station is expected to have a mass between 80 and 100 tons. Operations will be controlled from the Beijing Aerospace Command and Control Center in China. Next time on Discover Zen, we will be discussing, what would you eat on Mars? Thank you so much for watching our video. If you liked what you saw, click that like and subscribe button. Let us know in the comments below what you think of the space station situation. Until next time, friends.